Welcome children, welcome to English video lessons. Happy to see you all. This is a new day. Shall we celebrate this day? Usually, what do we celebrate? We celebrate the important days like birthday, marriages and festivals. Whenever we go for a celebration, we put on new clothes, don't we? Every day is a new day God has given us. So, we have to celebrate it. On this new day, I am going to introduce a new prose in celebration of being alive. It is a thought-provoking speech by Dr. Christian Bernard. Do you know about Dr. Christian Bernard? Let me say some interesting facts about Dr. Christian Bernard. Dr. Christian Bernard was a famous heart surgeon from South Africa. Have you seen him? This is Dr. Christian Bernard. He was born to poor parents as their fourth child. He was a very studious child. He was a hard worker. That's why he won many scholarships and pursued his higher education. How did he become a specialist in heart surgery? The death of his brother due to cardiac ailment made him to become a specialist in cardiac surgery. He performed the world's first human-to-human heart transplant in the year 1967. He developed many surgery techniques and became famous. He has written 14 books and 235 scientific articles. Some of his books are One Life, 50 Ways to a Healthy Heart, The Best Medicine, etc. He has received 37 international awards. He also established the Christian Bernard Foundation for the underprivileged children to serve them throughout the world. What a great personality he is. He lived a successful life. Have you understood, children? Now let us learn some hard words from the given text. What do you see in this picture? A man is thinking something carefully. Okay? So, thinking carefully, a careful thought is called consideration. So, consideration means careful thought. What do you see? You see disabled men. Disabled. So another word for disabled is cripples. Cripples means this pupil with some disability. Okay, cripples means pupil with some disability. What do you see in this picture? A man is feeling pain, isn't he? So pain, another word for pain is agony. Agony means extreme physical and mental suffering. The next new word is amputated. Amputated. What do you see in this picture? A man is sitting without a leg. Without a leg. So, amputated means cut off by surgical operation. Cut off by surgical operation. Nowadays, people are suffering from, many people are suffering from cancer. So, it is caused by tumor. So, here, you see in this picture, it's a malignant tumor. So, what do you mean by malignant tumor? It's very harmful, it's a very harmful tumor. So, malignant tumor means harmful tumor. Have you ever seen a disfigured face? Do you like disfigured face? Nobody likes, no? But due to some accident, some pupils' face are spoiled in appearance. So, that is disfigured. You see in this picture, pupil with disfigured faces. Okay. So, disfigured means spoiled in appearance. Spoiled in appearance. What is a lion noted for? A lion is noted for its boldness and daring. So, another word for boldness and daring is intrepid. Say the word intrepid. Intrepid means bold and daring. Intrepid means bold and daring. What do you see in this picture? Something is torn and damaged with holes. So, if anything is damaged with holes, that is perforated. So, the new word perforated means damaged with holes. Perforated means damaged with holes. Good. So far we have learnt 10 new words from this text. So, you have to use these new words in your day-to-day life. Then only you can learn more and more new words. Now, let's go to the lesson. In this prose piece, Dr. Barnard narrates an experience that changed his outlook of life altogether. So, what was his outlook of life? Do you have? What's your opinion about life? We all want to live a life without worries, without troubles, without difficulties. So, in the same way, Dr. Christian Barnard also, he wanted to live a life without suffering. So, here in this prose piece, he narrates an experience that changed his outlook of life altogether. When you read the first para, he regrets that out of 125 million born in that year, 12 million were hardly reach a year of life. 6 million die before 5 years of age. The rest of the children have physical and mental disabilities. He had a consideration towards the suffering of the children. In the second para, he shares his sad experience. So let's see what happened in his life. One day, Dr. Bernard and his wife went to a hotel to have meals. So after their meals, they were crossing the street. Suddenly, a car hit them. His wife was thrown into the other lane and was struck by a car coming from the opposite direction. Her shoulders got fractured. For the doctor, his 11 ribs were broken. They got severe injuries. They were hospitalized in a critical condition. Dr. Bernard, he couldn't tolerate the suffering. He was asking, why should we suffer? Why should he suffer? He was heartbroken to see the patients who were waiting for him to be operated and his baby who needed his mother's care. So he was in a distressed state. He remembered his father. His father had said, suffering is God's will. Everyone must undergo sufferings in life because suffering ennobles a person. That means suffering makes a better person. But for the doctor, he couldn't accept the view. So he was in a distressed state. He had a contrary view of suffering. Dear students, are you ready to face troubles that come in your life? We don't like troubles, no? We always expect only the good things in life. If I give you sweets the whole day, how do you feel? Is it good for your health? No. So for a healthy life, we must be able to face anything that come in our life. We should not bother about troubles and tribulations, because the more you face the difficulties, the more you will get the strength. So suffering ennobles a person. Suffering makes a better person. Okay. Now I am going to tell an incident that has changed Dr. Bernard's attitude towards suffering. Oh, let us see. One morning, Dr. Bernard witnessed an incident in a children's hospital at Cape Town. He saw two boys are playing with a breakfast trolley. They were patients. They were admitted in the hospital. So the boys were eagerly playing using the trolley. You see, two boys are playing with the breakfast trolley. One acted as the driver and the other acted as a mechanic. The driver was a one-armed boy. He had a heart problem. He also had a malignant tumor of the bone. His shoulder and arm were amputated. What is the meaning of amputated? We have already seen it. Amputated means cut off by surgical operation. surgical operation. The other boy who acted as a mechanic was totally blind. God has given us beautiful eyes, but that boy was blind. He was not blind by birth. He was made blind. You know how? One night, in his home, his father and mother were fully drunk. They had a quarrel between them. Out of anger, his mother threw a lantern at his father. Have you seen a lantern? This is lantern. His mother threw a lantern at his father. Unfortunately, it missed and it broke over the child's head and shoulders. He suffered, the boy suffered severe burns on the upper part of his body and lost his eyesight. What a terrible thing! Dr. Bernard, he describes the boy as a walking horror because his face was burnt. His face was disfigured. So what is disfigured? Spoiled in appearance. So everyone wants to be beautiful or handsome. Am I correct? Yes. But the boy lost his beautiful face and eyesight. So he came across such a terrible situation in his life. The one-armed boy and the blind boy, they were very happy. They didn't show any sadness. So they play happily, they were happy and made others happy. The one-armed boy who acted as a mechanic, he steered by scrubbing his foot on the floor. The blind boy, he provided motor power by pushing the trolley. Even though they were disabled, they provided a lot of entertainment to the other patients of the hospital. Dr. Bernard, who witnessed the incident, was moved by the attitude of the boys. They were small boys. How they are enjoying their life, you see. So, we have to learn a great lesson from that boy's attitude towards life. The two children taught a profound lesson to Dr. Bernard. He was moved by the joyful nature of the boys who were facing death. Yes, they were facing death. So this incident was an eye-opener to him. It enlightened his mind. So the author, he changed his attitude towards suffering. He says that the business of living is the celebration of being alive. So we have to celebrate because we are alive. That is the main thing we learn from this prose piece. Okay, so hereafter you must be happy at all times. He learned that, Dr. Bernard, he learned that suffering is necessary and being alive is important. He also learned that What have you lost is not important, but what have you left is very important. So we must be happy with what we have. Dear children, you have understood a great lesson from Dr. Bernard's speech. Yes, we have to celebrate every day for being alive. We should not lose hope when we suffer. If only we know the darkness, we can appreciate the light. If only we suffer cold, we can appreciate warmth. So, be happy always. So, you have to go through the text, line by line, read individually, read loudly. Then only you can improve your reading skill. Children, now let us look at the summary of the lesson. Dr. Bernard was the first surgeon to perform human heart transplantation surgery in the world. He had a negative attitude towards suffering in life. But what happened in his life at a children's hospital in Cape Town changed that view radically. He understood suffering ennobles the individuals. It lends a new and positive attitude towards suffering. It helps us to celebrate life as it is. Let's recall the hard words we have learned. What's the meaning of consideration? Careful thought. Consideration, careful thought. Cripples, pupil with some disability. Cripples, pupil with some disability. Next, agony. Agony means extreme physical and mental suffering. Tell me the other word for damaged with holes. Perforated. Perforated means damaged with holes. Grand prix. What do you mean by grand prix? Motor racing events. Motor racing events. Then solace. Solace means comfort. Solace, comfort. Intrepid, bold and daring. Finale, climax or an exciting end. Disfigured, spoiled in appearance. Malignant, very harmful to life. Tumor, diseased growth in some part of the body. Amputated, cut off by surgical operation. Amputated, cut off by surgical operation. Profound. Very great. Profound. Very great. That's all. So you have learnt a great lesson today. Let me ask few questions from the lesson we learned. Are you ready to answer? Okay, very good. The first question is very simple question. Who was Dr. Christian Barnard? You all know the answer? Yes. Dr. Christian Barnard was the first heart surgeon from South Africa. Okay. The second question is, what made Dr. Christian Barnard to take medicine? I know, you all know the answer. Try to say the answer. The death of his brother due to heart problem made him to take medicine. The third question. Tell some of his works. He wrote 14 books and 232 scientific articles. You just tell three famous books. Yes, One Life, 50 Ways to a Healthy Heart. What's the next one? Faith. Okay, good. What do you know about the blind boy? How he was made blind? The blind boy was not blind by birth. He was made blind because of their parents' quarrel. Correct? Yes. His mother, she threw a lantern at his father. It missed and it broke over the boy's head and shoulders. He suffered severe burns on his face and shoulders. That's why he lost his eyesight. Okay. What is the moral of the lesson? The moral of the lesson is the business of living is celebrating for being alive. Correct? Yes. So we must be able to face all the trials and tribulations that come in our life. We should celebrate every day as a special day. So sufferings make you stronger and a successful person. Thank you.
இந்நிகழ்ச்சியை பற்றிய தங்களின் மேலான கருத்துக்களை கீழ்கண்ட முகவரிக்கு கடிதம் மூலமாகவோ மின்னஞ்சல் மூலமாகவோ குறுஞ்செய்தி மூலமாகவோ தெரியப்படுத்தலாம். அனுப்ப வேண்டிய முகவரி: சிறப்பு அலுவலர், கல்வி தொலைக்காட்சி, 8ஆம் தளம், அண்ணா நூற்றாண்டு நூலகம், காந்தி மண்டப சாலை, கோட்டூர்புரம், சென்னை 685. தொலைபேசி எண் 7824001500.